this, you know what, I'll come back to, I'm still doing the attachment on the panels, but while I actually attach these on, I was going to tell you, relate some of my experiences, because this is a long and tedious process where I suppose we could do a lot of talking while we're doing this. And what I wanted to talk about was, you know, I do all these designs and I actually put them, you know, normally leave them downstairs or I show them to people. And funnily enough, one of the things that I get told is that, oh, you do all these wonderful designs, but you don't do them for us. You wear them yourself, but you don't do them for us. You know, what's the use of having such a wonderful design if you don't do them for us? And it's like, hold on, stupid people. I'm not doing them. I'm doing them for myself because I'm sacrificing my sleep, my time, my effort to actually do this for myself, which, you know what? You can do for yourself as well. And that's something that that's all the pieces inserted onto the other side as well. And do you know what, something has just cropped into my mind, and that is that if you remember, I actually cut 8 pieces for the one side and 8 pieces for the other side, and then I cut 8 pieces for my back. And actually my back doesn't have 8 pieces, it has 16 pieces. So I'm gonna attach a few, and then I'm gonna run short and I'm gonna have to go and cut another 8. This was something that totally while getting carried away with the talking and everything else, I forgot to mention. So my point is that if you want to dress, and I've covered this point many times in my briefs and talks, is that if you want something different, if you want something unique, if you want something totally, you know, different, then you are going to have to do, you're going to have to sacrifice your time, you're going to have to put effort into it, and you are going to have to do it yourself. Because you know what, I don't want to be a mug for no one, I don't want to do it for anyone. I would, you know, this isn't something that, you know what, do me a favor, do this for me. I'm sorry, right? Favors only cover certain things, and you know what, this is a hard favor to ask of anyone. This is a favor that you only do for yourself, or you can make serious money out of it. Now, I know the type of customers and the type of clientele we have. These clientele would happily, they don't value what you have, they don't value your talent, they don't value your expertise. They want to look like you, they want to be different, and they want to dress in something unique and classy and different, but they don't want to pay for it. And what they would do is they would take advantage wherever they can. And you know what, don't let anyone take advantage of you. If you make yourself special, I'm actually, thank you for saying this, I'm not one to practice this, so although I'm saying this, it's not something, you know, you should practice what you preach. And although I'm preaching it, I can't, you know, people, I've done it for so long for people that it's very difficult to actually now get out of the habit. So don't take people, let people take liberties, you know, don't let them take advantage of you, and value your own uniqueness and your own skills, and do it for yourself. Organize yourself, and I think any person who organizes themselves adequately can actually reap the rewards of their efforts. I think one of the things that we often, and this is for the majority of women, I mean, I talk to all kinds of people, and yesterday I was talking to a lad, and he was saying to me that we were talking about sewing, and he said, oh, will you sew my wife something like this? And I said, no, why should I sew it for your wife? You know, you get your wife to sew it for herself. And the remark that his actual words were that, you know what, she won't do it for herself. You know what our women are like, they're lazy. So, you know what, that's not my fault. If somebody is lazy, does that mean that I have to compensate for their laziness? No. If someone is lazy, then that's their downfall and that's their loss. And my encouragement and my motivation to anyone who's sewing is to, you know what, to organize yourself in such a way that you can fit stuff like this between your lifestyle. And it can be done, it's not impossible. It's because we waste valuable time. We waste valuable time on silly things. I mean, I have members of my own family, my girls in my family. And they are, what can I say? I know it's young age and, you want to sleep till late and you want to enjoy life. But I remember going back to my young days, and you know what, I used to wake up. You wake up for, say, early in the morning to drop the kids off at school, get them ready for school and do your housework. And you put your mind to it, you can drop the kids off at school, do your housework, organize yourself. And housework is nothing for someone I mean, at the moment, right, I've got a very, very busy schedule and my housework tends to just get left and left. But in the days when I was not doing this as a teaching thing, as a profession, my routine was that, you know, get the kids ready for school, drop them off at school, come back home, hoover, change, put the washing in the washing machine, do all my chores, and by 10 o'clock I used to be free, and then between 10 and 1 I used to do the work on the machine. And this was in the days, I mean, factory work is what I used to do, and used to sit on the machine, do about 3-4 hours of work, and then get up. And if it was short days, you know, you'd read your namaz, organize your food, and really by 3 o'clock you'd have, you know, your food cooked, yourself organized enough to actually let the kids come back home and feed them. And so it's organizing yourself in a proper, I know there's not enough hours in a day to actually, but even if you give yourself 3 hours of quality time on the sewing machine, do you know what? 3 hours is enough to actually get a lot of work done. 3 hours is, the way I would suggest anyone to utilize on that is to, that 3 hours, I would dedicate that to sewing. And the cutting, personally, my firm understanding on this is that in order to cut, I mean, in between you can watch the videos and see me do the stuff, but what you can do is, once the kids have gone to bed in the evening, give yourself a couple of hours to do the cutting and do the preparation, and put your suit out, prepare it. And when I say prepare it, prepare everything. When you cut it out, cut your neckline out, iron mark everything, prepare your thread and your accessories with it the night before, and then in the morning when you've done your housework, sit on the machine and start the sewing project. And guaranteed within the 3 hours you would have that suit sewn and you'd be wearing it for the Zohar prayer. So it's, I've only got the one cut out piece left, and I've still got to put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more panels. So I actually need 5 more panels of this. So I'm gonna have to put the camera on pause and go and cut a few more panels.